Facts First presents. When disabled workers were mocked at Pizzability, a devastated woman took matters into her own hands. Local businesses play an essential part in today's society. These smaller companies often provide more job opportunities than the large corporations. And there's a restaurant in Denver, Colorado called Pizzability, and it's different than most small companies. The owner of this business has made it his goal to give people with disabilities a chance to work. Each of the employees is disabled in some way. The owner helps the employees find ways to work around their respective limitations. When you know more about the owner, you'll understand why she hires people with disabilities. Tiffany Fixter is the owner of Pizzability. Before opening the restaurant, she worked as a teacher for special needs children. When she opened her restaurant, she wanted to continue to help people with special needs, so she decided to offer them jobs. Since Tiffany knew how to work with people with disabilities, she knew that she could help them work around those disabilities and be successful in their jobs. Pizzability opened its doors in the neighborhood of Cherry Creek in Denver. Many people were impressed by what Tiffany created in this business. Unfortunately, some people were less than impressed. In fact, it wasn't uncommon for people to actually mock Tiffany's employees. The food Tiffany served at her restaurant was delicious. Whether her customers wanted pizza, pasta dishes, salads, or appetizers, her employees could handle it. They knew the food and how to make it, and it always tasted great. Sadly, though, there were a few people who just couldn't get over the fact that the employees were disabled. In May of 2019, Tiffany did an interview with TheDenverChannel.com about her business, Pizzability. During the interview, she said, "Everybody on my staff has an intellectual or developmental disability. We have people that are blind and deaf. They have autism, Down syndrome, cerebral palsy." During her interview, she also discussed the Brewability Lab. It was the first business she opened in Denver, and this one, like Pizzability, is staffed only by disabled people. Tiffany says that she has to run her business differently than other business owners. Since she has experience teaching people with special needs, Tiffany knew what her employees needed in order to be successful. Since some of her staff members could read and some couldn't, she had to color code everything. When Tiffany opened Brewability Lab, its Facebook page earned over 6,000 likes and had over 6,500 followers. It also had 400 recommendations. When she saw how successful and popular her first business was, she opened Pizzability in 2018. She says that she only needed 6 employees at her brewery, and she wanted to offer more disabled individuals a chance, so she opened her second business. Tiffany turned her office into a sensory room for her employees. It's a place for them to go if they start feeling overwhelmed or need a break. After spending a few minutes in the room, her employees are able to calm down, refocus, and return to work. She also created a checklist for her employees so that they could work independently without her needing to tell them what to do at all times. And that gave her employees the confidence they needed. Tori Mason is a reporter for CBS4 and a regular customer at Pizzability. Not only does she love the food, she also appreciates that Tiffany's created a happy workplace for people who are disabled. After talking to Tiffany for a bit, Tori was furious because Tiffany told her that people stand outside, afraid to come in. Some people walk by and say, and please forgive the language, but this is a quote, "That's where the retards work." She says the employees often hear these comments. Tori was furious about the things that Tiffany told her, so she took to Facebook to vent. "I'm furious just having to say that word." In her Facebook post, Tori wrote about the horrible things that she'd heard from Tiffany. She went on to say, "I'm heartbroken and disgusted because this place is built on acceptance and love. Please give them your business and your tolerance. Don't go because you feel bad. Go because the pizza and service are darn good." Well, it didn't take long for Tori's post to go viral. In a short time, the post had over 6,000 likes and over 6,000 shares. There were also over 1,400 comments on the post. Most people were supportive of Tiffany's businesses. Most of the people who commented mentioned their wonderful experiences at both businesses. One person wrote, "I go in and buy a soda every time I work in the area. Everyone is so helpful and kind. I'll always support this place and its employees." When disabled workers were mocked at Pizzability, a devastated woman took matters into her own hands. She wanted to let people know what a fantastic thing the owner was doing for the disabled people in the community. She also wanted people to know that they could handle the job because the food was excellent. Tori wanted the world to know that just because a person has a disability, it doesn't mean that they can't do everything everybody else can do. Tiffany's businesses have made a difference, and so did Tori's Facebook post. And I'm planning on moving to the Denver area someday, and you can guess what the first two businesses I go to will be. Subscribe for more.